Another great natural light show, fireflies. Catching fireflies is a magical memory in many of our childhoods. But in tonight's Earth Care, we look at why some people worry those moments are vanishing. Morgan Wolf meets a family determined to enjoy them while they can, while also making sure they're around in the future.
In about an hour, it will just light up as far as you can see of just flashing fireflies all over the place.
5 years ago,
oh, there you go,
Katie Kelch and her family fell in love with fireflies.
The sea of glitter in our backyard is an incredible sight to see.
But then,
that was in 2019.
The family moved.
Things that we were looking for in a new house is kind of an environment that mimicked our old house, which would be a habitat for fireflies.
And they found it. There is a marsh right behind their neighborhood, a perfect environment for these insects that thrive in areas with wet, warm summers and cold winters.
We have lots of mosquitoes. With fireflies come mosquitoes.
There is one. But mosquitoes don't do this.
Magical, inspirational, peaceful, childlike.
Oh, there's one.
I'll catch him for you. Got one.
It's truly just magical. There's no other word to describe it.
A whimsical reality.
Oh, there goes one.
In the woods.
It's really cool how they like flash and stuff.
I think every child, no matter their ability, should have this as one of their memories, one of their core childhood memories of catching fireflies.
I did it.
You did do it.
As McKinley and her cousins ran through the forest in search of the fireflies, Katie was counting them.
Females generally are stationary where the males are flying.
She's a part of Firefly Atlas, a community-based science project tracking data around the beloved bioluminescent insects, which are actually a beetle with over 2,000 different types of species. The project launched after people noticed the fireflies were starting to vanish. 14% of North American firefly species are threatened or classified as critically endangered. And that number could be much higher. Experts say we just don't know enough because there are not enough scientists out there studying it, but they do know the reasons why it's happening.
So they believe habitat loss, getting rid of the forest and the damp soil and the water sources is the number one reason why we're losing so many of them.
And pesticides. Some are adapting in different regions, mostly seen in Minnesota though, starting the end of June and into July.
Say, firefly, where are you?
But witnessing their glow these days may feel more special.
Look it, I have one right here.
Because it's getting more rare.
Oh yeah.
It just makes it such an incredible moment.
Let's fly.
In Prior Lake, Morgan Wolf, Care 11 News.
Into the sky.
Oh, here's one.
To keep fireflies around, researchers recommend homeowners don't spray their yards with pesticides and herbicides. They also say if you can tolerate the weeds, mow less, and you can attract fireflies. If you're interested in tracking them like Katie, we've linked information on our website. Oh, I really liked watching that story because that is a memory for so many of us. I remember even I grew up in the city and being able to catch fireflies as a kid.
I think so too, and I grew up on the St. Croix. And I have to say, when we were glamping the Saturday morning team, we were with Sammy Selena. She's from LA. She lived in Alaska. She lived in Hawaii. She'd never seen a firefly. And right by the campsite was this cornfield.
Oh, wow.
Lauren, there were hundreds. It was pretty remarkable. So that
awesome.
Was really cool. And I hadn't seen them since I was a kid. So that was really cool as well. So, yeah, hopefully folks will remember all those tips. That's for sure.